Hello everyone and welcome back to Voice. This week what we're gonna do is build off of the lessons that we had in the last two sessions. Now we started off with connecting with vowels and emotions, and then consonants and how those consonants can help shape those emotions. Well now what we're gonna do is combine those into words. Now what is the power that a word has, and how can you harness that power within your acting process and within your voice to connect to yourself, to your character, and express the text fully? Well, we're gonna go over that today. So let's get started. This week, what we are going to explore is a speech by King Lear. This is one of the most famous speeches of all time, but what we are going to do is break apart the speech into individual components, specifically words within the speech. So we're gonna bust the entire thing apart, explore each individual word, and then we're gonna bring it all together. I'll give you the given circumstances, and then we're gonna see if the work that we did exploring the words can help us connect with the text in our delivery of the speech. So the first thing that I want you to do is find a space where you can move around. And the first word that we're gonna explore is, I want you to imagine for a moment that you are wind. Look down at your hands and imagine that they become one with the air. And move throughout the space as though you were wind. Give yourself a sound. What sound would that make? Good. Now if wind were to blow, and you had to use the sound in the words blow, how would you move throughout the space? Blow. Now move throughout the space and explore what that feels like. Now if you're wind, now rage as the wind. Rage is really, really full anger. So now if you are wind, rage, what kind of sound would that make? And then use your sound, your mouth, to make that sound, rage. But use the air, be wind as you're exploring it. Good, use your mouth, feel it. And now rest. Now look at your hands and imagine that you're made of water. And move throughout the space as though you were liquid and you were water. Good. And now the pressure's building up and you're going to be a waterfall or a cataract. And now I want you to fall and move. What are the sounds of a waterfall? But now the sound you can make is either water sounds, but I want you to incorporate those and use them when you say cataract. But I want you to move throughout the space and use that sound, cataract. Use those consonants, explore them, explore how they feel. Good. Now the wind is starting to pick you up and give you strength and power, and it's throwing you against things. And now you are a hurricane. A hurricane, but I'm gonna add Shakespeare's word and it's going to be a hurricaneo. Now, as a hurricaneo, move throughout the space and now your gift is that O at the end. A hurricaneo, right? So now, that's gonna help you move throughout the space. So move, hurricaneo. Now, as a hurricaneo, I want you to drench something. Now, when you drench it, when something's drenched, like if you walk in from the outside and you're saying, I'm drenched, you're sopping wet, right? So now, as a hurricane, go and drench things. Everything you see, cover, submerge. Good, now cover it so much that you drown something. I want you to move throughout the space as this hurricane. Remember, you are wind, you are water, and drown things. How does that make you feel? Are you angry? Are you sad? What kinds of feelings come with it? And I want you to say that word as you do it. Drown. What does that feel like? Okay. Keep moving. All right. So now, go ahead and stop. Shake it off. Now I want you to imagine that you're fire. I want you to imagine that you are moving in your fire. And you're gonna move throughout the space and you're gonna burn things. But you're not just moving slowly. At first, I want your fire to be coming up from hell. And with that, there's gonna be sulfur. It's gonna be a sulfurous fire. So with this sulfurous fire, I want you to go and invade slowly, but I want you to say sulfurous as you are fire, moving around. And see how sulfurous makes you feel. Explore that word, explore that feeling. And now you're starting to pick up and pick up and pick up. And now I want you to vaunt. Now, if you ever don't understand a word, go and look it up, but to vaunt. Vaunt, it's even in the word, right? It's to jump, to move, to leap, to vaunt. I want you to vaunt around the room as fire, but I want you to say vaunt. Move throughout the space. Use the sound to propel you forward. Good. Now I want you to execute things. Execute. How does fire execute things? An execution. You're going to kill things. How does fire do that? How does fire feel about it? Good. And now, singe. If you've ever had hairs that have been caught on fire, they singe and they burn up, right? So now, as fire, go and singe things, but say singe as you singe. Move throughout the space. Good. Now stop, shake it off. Look at your hands. Imagine that you're thunder, but all shaking thunder. All shaking and shake. Shake and move throughout the space. How does shaking make you feel, especially as you say shake, grab things and shake it and yell shake? Shake! How does that make you feel? Move throughout the space. And now smite. If you had the power to shake things, how would you smite something? When you smite something, it's gone and every part of its existence is gone, so smite. And now, look around and be big and rotund. You're round. You're fat, you're rotund. And move throughout the space. Good. And now imagine that you crack open and say crack, crack. Now go and crack things. Crack, crack, crack. And imagine that germs spill out. All kinds of gross things, bugs, things pour out of what you crack. And now shake it off. Imagine that you're a dragon and you spit fire. Spit, spit. Move throughout the space and spit. Spout. What's the difference between spitting and spouting? Spit and spout. Move throughout the space. And stop. Shake it off. So now that we've explored those words and those sounds, now I want you to take a look at the speech. In the play, what I'm going to do first is give you a little bit of context. King Lear is a king, and in the very beginning of the play, he decides that he's going to split his kingdom, and he's going to give his kingdom away to whichever daughter loves him the most. Now he has two daughters that do not love him at all, and he has one daughter who actually does. And it's kind of his way, I would imagine, of giving the kingdom to the daughter that he really likes. Well, he decides that he's going to give the kingdom to whoever loves him the most. So he has this big ceremony, and the two daughters that don't like him, they just pour it on and tell him how much they love him. And his daughter who actually does love him says, no, I don't want to play this game. I don't like it. And he gets so angry that He gives the kingdom away to the two daughters who don't love him, and he banishes his daughter. Well, then he himself also gets banished. So he finds himself a once great king, now the king of nothing. And everyone, the one person who actually loved him, he feels betrayed by. So he is filled with all of these angry, sad, hurt emotions. And he's walking around the countryside with his fool, the jester. And one night, there's a storm. And the jester wakes up, and he sees the king, who's already losing his mind. And the king strips down, and he's basically standing naked, looking out at this storm on a cliff. And he says that speech. Knowing what you know now, what he's doing is he's asking the storm to come. He's asking the storm to come and to give as much destruction as possible. Why? Because he feels destroyed. And no matter what that storm does, it could not be his daughters. It couldn't be what they did to him. So I want you to take that speech and say it. Imagine that you're there. Blow. Blow winds and crack your cheeks. Rage! Blow. You cataracts and hurricanoes, spout till you have drenched our steeples. Drown the cocks! You sulfurous and thought-executing fires. Vaunt couriers to oak-cleaving thunderbolts. Singe my white head! And thou, all shaking thunder, smite flat the thick rotundity of the world. Crack nature's molds, and germens all spill out that make up ingrateful man. Rumble thy bellyful! Spit fire! Spout rain! Nor rain, wind, thunder, fire are my daughters. Take that speech. Use it. Move it. Try it as many different ways as you can. Try it a bunch of different times so that you can connect to the feeling. And what we're doing is we're using our words and the exploration of the words, the power within the word, to help anchor what you're saying. That's what we want to do. Have you ever heard somebody say something and it scared you? Maybe they said they loved you, but what they meant was hate, and it came out in there. One of the most powerful memories that I have was I was watching one of my best friends on stage, and in this one moment, she had one line where she said, the play was Intimate Apparel, and she said, I am worthy. I am worthy. Those are the lines. And she looked at her scene partner, and she said, I am worthy. And she started to break down, and she said, I am worthy. And she said that word with such power that I get goosebumps 12 years later thinking about it. That's the power you have in your words. So what I want you to do is I want you to go through this exercise, take your time to make sure you're feeling it, and then I want you to upload your experience. And if possible, I also want you to record yourself doing the speech and upload it so I can see it too. I want to see what words you connect with. All right, everyone. I can't wait to see your videos and hear about your experiences. And I'll see you soon.